First, thanks, governance now and Broadcom for bringing such a good kind of event here. And today, as our previous speakers have spoken all about most of the smart infrastructure, which, you know, whether it's the government, whether it's the private sector, or any industry, you know, we are moving towards everything smart, right from infrastructure to applications to users, you know, mostly. The beneficiaries, the users which we are talking about. Now coming back to passport Seva as a whole, or let's say I go a little deeper, if I talk about e-governance as a whole, you know, the day we conceptualized, started conceptualizing e-governance in the year 2005-06, which fortunately I was part of that core team. And today what we are realizing that we have moved forward. Much ahead. We are much ahead the day we conceptualized in 2005 and today where we are standing in 2018. And the day we started, we are only thinking about, you know, digitization and probably consolidation kind of a thing. But today we have much ahead move from consolidation to automation, and now from automation to analytics, and you know, leveraging more and more. Now when we are moving towards automation, from consolidation to automation and then analytics, and definitely now today we are all talking about whether it is AI or IoT, or it is a smart infrastructure, or it is a smart city. Now, the security and privacy of the data is bound to come, because today you are no more of a kind of a traditional boundaries. We have all become borderless. We have all become, you know, boundaryless. There is no network today, if you ask me. There is no network today. The concept of network is gone, right? So it's all become, we all are boundaryless. Everyone sitting here, we are part of a network, but you are not within the network, right? Issue. Because ultimately, again, we are also collecting the public data, citizen data. And not only we are collecting the citizen data, but also we are collecting the biometric data on top of, you know, demographic data.
This increases the data size.
Yeah. Not only the data size, but concerns on privacy and how we maintain it. Now, two most important things, you know, everyone has to understand when you do this big exercise, especially in government parlance, when we are dealing with the public, when we are dealing with the volume of masses, citizen as a whole. We need to understand that why you are collecting such data for any purpose, for issuance of a passport, for issuance of a driving license, for issuance of a let's say GSTN service or railway kind of a service, anything, income tax service. The first and foremost thing we all need to understand that whether the data being collected for this purpose is, that purpose is met. I mean, are you collecting data for sort of collecting, or is there a purpose out of it? Whether the principle of the data, I mean, the citizen is aware of, or have you ever taken consent of the citizens or the principle of the data, that what for you are collecting this data? What is the purpose? How will you store this data? How will you leverage this data? How will you, you know, disclose this data to other government agencies or public authorities or private authorities, or how you share this data? But unless you have your own thing analyzed and, you know, conceptualized within, that you are not even clear of why you are collecting that data, then securing that data or maintaining the privacy of that data becomes even much more difficult if you don't have started with that principle. And that we have not done. Passport Seva, we have not done that. We understand that why we are collecting the data, whether it is biometric data or it is demographic data. So that is the first principle of any data we manage within or outside the organization. The second principle of the, you know, data protection and data privacy, which probably after the Honorable Supreme Court has come out a heavy kind of this thing on privacy, saying that privacy is my fundamental right, and then this Krishna committee has come up, right?
Yeah.
So the second important point of once we have collected the data, the problem is again harnessing of that data. How do you harness that? For an example, let's say today I have collected data of my citizens in passport Seva for issuance of a passport, but I am doing much more now. For an example, tomorrow I will issue an e-passport. When I issue an e-passport, the same citizen data and biometric which I have collected, probably I use in the e-passport. And the use of the e-passport will become a next phase of the citizen data, which may become global. Now, we have collected the citizen data for a purpose, probably we didn't use by government of India, but tomorrow when I go to e-passport, issuance of e-passport, the same demographic data and the biometric data becomes global. Because now I'll have to talk within two countries. I'll have to share probably that biometric data for validation purpose at least. Now, if that is the case, have you, guided by your laws, guided by your regulations to do that? Probably not as of now. Because government of India do not have that practice or that production law as of now. Now, if that is the case, how as a ministry I deal with the citizens' data? So that is another concern, another big area of concern which probably all of government agency, whether it is Aadhaar or whether it is external affairs, we are dealing with that. And probably government of India is very shortly coming with
Sir, I'd like to add, sir, with the amount of data which is increasing, how would you like to see your infrastructure grow? And another part is, you may be having separate data centers. Now, in the future, there could be passport validation at the airport itself. A high-speed network is needed, and the exchange of data between the airport or police authorities would increase manifold. Do you have some plans?
That's already happening, in fact. Even today, we are having access to the police authority, we are having access to all the immigration check posts, border control check posts here within India and outside India also. When I talk about our embassies and consulates abroad. But you have a point to say that, is that the traditional infrastructure is going to help? Probably our colleague from Broadband was trying to explain that, saying that the traditional infrastructure is no more or no way is going to help you when you are looking at this kind of a data eligibility or usage of a data, or let's say the boundary is increasing, the volume base is increasing, the user base is increasing. So you have to come out of your traditional way of building a data center or traditional way of giving access to the users and public. That you have to come out of that, and probably we are doing that. For an example, when I'm very happy to even inform all of you that the same passport Seva, we have now become global. We have extended the same passport Seva to all our Indian embassies and consulate abroad. That means my all Indian diaspora living abroad can access the same passport Seva system. They will feel the same experience when it comes to services, in terms of having a passport related services. Now, while doing that, do you think that the data center which I had created probably 10 years ago and which are located within India, let's say Delhi and data center, we had active data center, could have helped me to do that? No, absolutely not. But for that to happen, I had to create 4 cloud casing zones globally, and then without disturbing the principle, as I said, fiduciary principle of the data and application, my data layer and application layer still remains within India. However, I am able to service all my consulates and embassies abroad. So that is the way probably you have to plan it out.
Sir, any plans which you have in the next 5 to 10 years, any technological changes which you might be seeing?
Oh, yes, definitely. I mean, if you ask
new technologies which is going to come out,
absolutely. So, if you ask me, as I said, the going forward technology would be definitely mobility is going to be much and much more. So, if you see more and more technology intervention or more and more technology exploitation will happen on the mobility side. The second sort of technology which will impact all of us will be analytics. A lot of analytics will be happening. And the industry colleague present here, or the citizen as a whole we are present here, we'll see that whatever data we collect, there will be analytics out of it. Right? Today data we are talking about, data is a good, data is a wealth. So unless you analyze it, unless you have analytics of that, how do you get that oil or money you are looking for. The third thing definitely on the technology for will emerge towards the IoT and artificial intelligence. Probably again, as part of Passport Seva, we are trying to infuse some sort of artificial intelligence so that globally, wherever citizens are, whether it is in India, availing a passport related services or availing a service outside, can they get benefit of these two technology, whether it is analytics or artificial intelligence. And on top of it, you'll see that there are a lot of IoT based system will evolve, whether it is a smart city, whether it is a smart infrastructure, more or less things will be based on sensors. And then analytics will happen on top of it.
Probably automating police verification.
Police have already done that. More or less, we have already done that.
Okay. Anyway, thank you, sir, for your good time.
Thank you.
We would definitely like to see you in the future also, sir.
Thank you.